Well, good morning, boys and girls, and thanks for joining me for today's Bible Zone video. Today, we're going to get started with our action memory verse, followed by the Bible story time, and then we'll finish with a Bible Zone praise song. Are you ready to have some fun? All right, here we go. So our action memory verse is from the book of Psalms, chapter 19, verse 1. And it says this, it says, "The heavens declare the glory of God." Now, when we say heavens, it's not heaven, like where God is. Heavens means like everything beyond the sky, like all of outer space and the stars, the moon, the sun, all of those amazing things that God has created. It says the heavens declare, that means it's almost like they are speaking, even though they're not really speaking. It's almost like they're telling us, like, look how amazing God is. So it says the heavens declare the glory of God, the greatness, the majesty of who God is. He's so powerful and amazing. So let's do it now with the actions. Are you ready? Okay, so we're gonna say Psalms chapter 19, verse 1. The heavens declare the glory of God. Did you get that? Let's do it one more time. Psalms chapter 19, verse 1. The heavens declare the glory of God. Excellent. Last week's video was called Jesus Came to Be the Sacrifice for Sin. Let's see what happens in this week's video.
Jesus was in Jerusalem for the Passover feast. One night, a religious man came to see Jesus. The man's name was Nicodemus. Nicodemus was a Pharisee. He studied and taught God's law, and he tried very hard to obey the law. Nicodemus wanted to know more about Jesus. "Rabbi," he said, "we know that you are a teacher who has come from God. No one could do the miracles you do unless God were with him." Jesus said, "I tell you, unless someone is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." Now Nicodemus was confused. He thought that keeping all God's laws was how a person got into heaven. Besides, what Jesus said didn't make any sense to him. "How can anyone be born when he is old?" Nicodemus asked. Jesus said, "A person cannot enter God's kingdom unless he is born of water and the Spirit. Whatever is born of the flesh is flesh, and whatever is born of the Spirit is spirit. When a baby is born, he gets physical life from his parents. Physical life doesn't last forever, but the Spirit gives people a better kind of life, spiritual life, so they can live with God forever." Jesus said, "Don't be surprised I told you that you must be born again." Nicodemus still didn't understand. "How is this possible?" he asked. Jesus said, "When you don't believe what I say about things I've seen on earth, how will you believe what I say about the things I've seen in heaven? Do you remember how Moses raised up the bronze snake in the wilderness? Everyone who looked at it was healed. Like that, the Son of Man will be raised up, so that everyone who believes in him will have eternal life." Then Jesus told Nicodemus about God's great plan. Jesus said, "God loved the world in this way. He gave his one and only Son, so that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life. God did not send his Son to declare the world guilty, but to save the world. Anyone who believes in him is found not guilty. But anyone who does not believe in him is guilty already." Nicodemus needed new life, eternal life, but he could not do anything to earn it. Eternal life is a gift that comes only from God. God showed his love in this way. He sent his one and only Son to save the world. Everyone who believes in him will not perish, but will have eternal life.
So Nicodemus was a Pharisee. That means that he was one of the religious leaders, one of the teachers of the law. Now he knew that Jesus had come from God because he saw and heard about all the miracles that Jesus was doing. But he just wanted to know more about Jesus. So that's why he came to him. Now, if you think about it, today we have the Bible. So we know more about what Jesus did and who he is, and we have the whole story. But back then, he wasn't sure. So he wanted to know more, and he came to talk to Jesus. Now, Jesus said to him, that sounded really confusing. In fact, it sounds a little bit crazy. Jesus said to him, in order to get into heaven, someone must be born again. Now, you and I are thinking, what are you talking about, Jesus? We can only be born once. We're in our mommy's tummy and then we're born and that's it. We're born. How can we be born again? Well, Jesus said to him, you have to be born again, not of the flesh, not like our natural bodies. You have to be born again of the spirit. That means who we are on the inside. And the reality is that all of us are sinners. We're born as sinners. That means that we do the wrong thing. We disobey God. We do that just naturally. So in order to get into heaven, we have to be born again. We have to be born again on the inside. And the only way that can be happen is for Jesus to come in and resurrect our old selves, our sinful selves, and to give us a new heart, a new desire, a new spirit, to give us his spirit. And we do that when we trust and follow after Jesus and repent of our sins, turn away from our sins. And then when we do that, he gives us his Holy Spirit. And that's how we're born again. So boys and girls, you might ask the question, how can I learn about what the Bible is teaching if I find it confusing? Now that's a really good question. And the truth is that all of us are going to find things in the Bible that are kind of hard to understand. So the best way that we can learn more about it is, number one, to pray to God, to admit that we don't have all the answers, we don't know everything. So we can come to God and pray to him and ask him through his Holy Spirit to help us understand what the Bible is teaching. Now, another really important way that we can learn more about things in the Bible that we don't understand is by coming to church and listening to our pastor, listening to our Bible Zone teacher to understand what it is that God wants us to know. So the more that we study God's Word, the more that we come to church and listen to our Bible Zone lessons, we're going to learn and understand more. But we need to continue to do that and continue to pray to God and ask him to help us understand what he wants us to know. All right, boys and girls, it's time for our Bible Zone praise song. So I want you to get ready to sing and dance and have some fun. The song that we're going to do today is called Restart. And this song is reminding us that Jesus gives us a fresh start on life. And we've been learning about how we need to be born again. We need to have new life, and only God can give us that. So let's think about that as we sing this song, Restart.
Game over, couldn't carry the weight on my shoulders. At my end, in trouble, knocked down on the ground, seeing double. But then your love, love, opened my eyes, lifted me up, up, now I'm alive. I raise my hands, hands to the sky, singing oh. Second chance, I was lost, I was falling apart. But you came along, you hit the restart. You hit the restart. You hit the restart. You hit the restart. You came along, and you hit the restart. I was twisted, like bad religion, fully committed to my way of living. I heard the preacher, but never listened, on a dead end road without a mission. you do. You're making me new. You make all things new. That's just what you do.
Okay, boys and girls, before we close in our prayer time, I want to remind you, if you have any questions at all about anything you saw or heard today, or anything you might want to know about God or the Bible, I'd love to help answer those questions. So you can email me at the email address below, but make sure you get mom or dad's permission first. All right, let's pray to God. Dear God, I thank you that you sent Jesus to forgive us our sins, but also that you sent Jesus to show us how much you love us. And I thank you, Jesus, that you don't just tell us you love us, you showed it by dying on the cross. And there are so many things that we can learn about you in the Bible. So help us to read the Bible in order to understand more about who you are and how much you love us. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Boys and girls, thank you so much for watching today's video. And remember, we can know that God loves us because he gave us Jesus to forgive the sins of the world. I'll see you next week.